Welcome to our summer series of Design Between the Lines live interviews with the winners of ISFD's inaugural Innovation and Design Maker Designer Competition. Scott Stevens is this year's Professional Best of Show Innovation and Design winner. His piece, Little Leafy, embodies the relationship between the natural and manufactured worlds, between yin and yang, the dark and light. Made of black walnut, each of the 10 leaf sections were uniquely chosen and jointed to fit in a particular position. Beautiful sanding and sculpting allow its organic, natural design influence to show through. Scott joins us today from Nelson, British Columbia. Scott, welcome to Design Between the Lines Live.
Hi, John. Thanks for having me.
Well, you're welcome. This is solid black walnut, right?
Yep.
How thick is the top of that piece?
Overall, it's about 1.25 inches thick, but it was, you know, a good 0.75 to 2 inches. And it had to be because the tip of the leaf tapers down as if it's wilting away. So it has that flowing effect.
I love the look. Where'd the idea come from? What were you thinking about when this thing popped into your head?
It was a real simple, innocent source for that. We needed a new coffee table for our space. And the way that our living room is laid out, it wouldn't accept a standard square or rectangular table very well. I was brainstorming ideas of like how can we make something that would fit this space a little better. I had this really beautiful chunk of black walnut that I bought for a previous project. As I was thinking about it more, I was in my sketchbook drawing some stuff out, and I don't know about you, but my sketchbook goes back years and years and years, and I've got all sorts of ideas of things that I wanted to build but never really got around to. And I was flipping through that, and I stumbled upon these leaf shapes that I'd drawn years ago for another table that I wanted to do, and I thought, hey, hang on, that's an interesting concept that would really work well with the space. And Little Leafy was born.
Well, I have to say I love the name. You talked about keeping your sketchbook. So what goes in there?
It's a smorgasbord of ideas. Sometimes I'm working on a very intentional piece that I'm working on for a client. Other times I'm just inspired. I'm, you know, I want to walk and I see something. It's like, oh, I want to draw that. Or sometimes I'm looking for inspiration. You know, I need to work on something and I'm kind of stuck. I think it's good to have a collection of ideas.
Mm-hmm. I guess you're open to doing new projects?
Always looking for new projects. Yeah, I think that's important to staying sharp and staying relevant.
If someone were to connect with you to give you a project, how would they do that?
Well, I do have a website. It's www.edwardscottwoodwork.ca.
Okay.
So they can reach out to me there.
I'm going to go back to the sketchbook one more time. Would you say that this would be one of your major recommendations to any student that might be listening to this podcast?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I think it's important from a designer and a maker point of view. One, as a designer, for obvious reasons that you need to work through your designs, but also as a maker to finalize little details, how like construction details or construction techniques I work through there. And it's an important step to go through in getting your ideas out onto paper before we go into some kind of drafting program like SketchUp or AutoCAD. I'm a woodworking instructor in Nelson here, and that's one of the major points that we pass on to our students here is keep a sketchbook, and at the end of the year we love looking through them and seeing what people have actually achieved, both in their design but also in their drawing skills.
What age group of students do you have in your classes?
It's a post-secondary institution, so we're seeing students who are coming out of high school who are in the 18, 19 years old. This year we had a lot of students in their late 20s, early 30s who are considering career changes or who have always just thought woodworking to be interesting and they wanted to give it a shot. We have people who are in their 40s who just bought a house and they want to learn how to do woodworking a little bit better, and other people who are retired. And they finally have some time to actually explore the art and the craft.
Wow, that's awesome. I love the ability to give people the opportunity to change career directions when they feel a need or when, let's face it, the buggy whip goes out of style and they've got to think of something else to do.
At a minimum, I think that, especially in our modern society where a lot of a lot of our creative impulses have been kind of pushed aside and quelched. People are still looking for a way to make and create and to do things with their hands, and woodworking is a natural place to go.
And speaking of natural, you mentioned in your write-up how strongly connected you are with nature. Tell me a little bit more about that, and where did that come from?
It's always been with me, even if I haven't known it. I grew up in a big city on the prairies where we had big rolling wheat fields and beautiful sunsets and storms that came in, and that always fascinated me. But there was always a piece of me that was drawn to the mountains, and as I moved on in my life, that is eventually where I ended up in a mountainous town. There's a sense of peace and tranquility that I find when I go into those natural elements that gives me the ability to reset. And I find that so important when I'm working on a project that I'm finding to be quite difficult, or I'm facing some kind of struggle in my life. It's a great place to go and reset and get a little bit of perspective.
Awesome.
And of course, that leads right back into my work. So often, so much of my work is inspired by not necessarily specific details, but the aura, the sensation that I get through those natural interactions.
Well, you definitely are in a beautiful part of the world. You really are. Tell me, what drew you into what you're doing now? What were the steps along the way?
Well, honestly, John, I didn't really have a choice. I'm actually a fourth generation woodworker. Oh, my dad. My dad was a career cabinet maker. He had a big shop where I was growing up in Edmonton, big family shop that I literally grew up in. As my first job was pushing a broom when I was in the sixth grade. My grandpa was a cabinet maker. My great grandpa was a chair maker back in England. So it's quite literally in my blood. And so from a young age, I was kind of following dad around and helping him out on projects. And you know, through school, I was working on the weekends or in the summers in the shop, developing my love and appreciation for the art. And despite a brief foray into academia in post-secondary education, I studied commerce at the University of Alberta. I quickly realized that sitting at a desk and doing paperwork and wearing suits wasn't for me. So eventually I fell back on cabinet making and woodworking, and been there ever since.
Well, you mentioned one person who inspired a piece that you've worked on. Tell me other makers or designers that inspire you.
That's a great question. So James Krenoff was for a time a big inspiration for me, not necessarily for the style of work that he created, but for his mantra of keeping things simple and doing things well. I've taken a lot of inspiration from a man named Wharton Eschrich. He was an American sculptor who developed his love affair with wood and sculpture, and his work is so organic and beautiful, and no two pieces are alike.
That is wonderful. Well, on that note, let me thank you for being a part of our program today and wish you lots of luck and success going forward.
Thank you, John.
This episode of Design Between the Lines Live is brought to you by International Market Centers and the International Society of Furniture Designers. To find videos of these live interviews, be sure to subscribe to the International Society of Furniture Designers YouTube channel. To learn more about ISFD, visit isfd.org.